Hello, my name is Bart Monnee. I'm from the Customer Support International Department, and I'm going to show you the PNOZmulti for burner applications. As you may know, the PNOZmulti is a compact safety controller for several safety functions. It's also suitable for burner control. For this purpose, it is equipped with a function block for safety for burner control. The PNOZmulti system consists of a base unit and several I/O modules and a module for field bus communication. For burner applications, we have a separate base unit. It's called the PNOZ MB1 burner. The PNOZmulti system is certified according to CL3 and PLE, and it's also certified according to several burner standards. First of all, the complete safety family is certified according to EN298 and EN5156. And the burner function block is certified according to application standards like EN267 and EN676 for burners, the EN746 part 2 and EN12952 and 953 for burner installations. It's also certified according to North American standards, in this case the UL6730. It's listed as a burner management system and is also certified according to NFPA 85, 86 and 87. And now I'm going to show you how this function block is configured. In the first step, we configure the hardware. We start with the base unit, in this case the PNOZ MB1 burner. And then we add some I/O modules. For instance, a module with 8 inputs and 4 semiconductor outputs, and a relay module. Now we can go to the user program. Here you see the workspace for the program, and at the right you see several functions. First of all, just normal safety functions, machine safety functions, and here we have a category for the burner controller. This is the burner controller function block. We can select it, pull it in, and place it in the workplace. The block starts with a wizard for the configuration of the block. And there are several steps to configure this wizard. The first step is where we select the burner type. There are so-called master burners and slave burner. Master burner means that the combustion air is included in the sequence. Slave burner means the combustion air is not included in the sequence. Master burner is, for instance, the case at single burners. Slave burners may be the case at multi-burner installations where the combustion air is controlled centrally. In this example, we start with the most complex configuration. Afterwards, I will show you the most simple configuration. So we select the master burner. Here we can select direct ignition, meaning without ignition burner, and indirect ignition, meaning with ignition burner, and there we can select joint flame monitoring or separate flame monitoring for main flame and ignition flame. The same we can configure for the slave burner. In this case, we can configure the compound controller. The PNOZmulti does not include a compound controller, but it can communicate and interface with an external compound controller. If we select this, signals for the external compound controller are available and are included in the sequence. Signals, for instance, to communicate to the compound controller that it should go into prepared, and an input signal in that case would be the confirmation of the compound controller that it is in the prepared position. the same applies to the ignition position. In a next step, we can configure the combustion air. In this case, it is only a debounce time. Here we can configure ignition. We can configure whether the ignition valve remains open or is closed after ignition. We can also configure high temperature mode. In this case, a separate input for the high temperature mode appears, as we can see afterwards. If the high temperature is enabled, then by an external signal coming from a temperature monitoring, the high temperature mode can be activated in the sequence. In that case, the flame monitoring and the tightness control are deactivated. Here we can configure the tightness control. We can configure whether the venting takes place via a separate vent valve or via a safety valve too. Also possible is a continuous vent where the vent valve is opened all the time during so both safety valves are closed. And it's also possible to deactivate the tightness control completely. If the tightness control is activated, we can select whether the tightness control takes place prior to ignition, meaning during pre-purge, or after burner shutdown. Here we can configure the shutdown of the burner, whether the safety valve 2 is opened or is closed during afterburn. Here we can select some error reactions. The standards allow a safety shutdown with automatic restart only in certain cases. And it is possible to configure this here. By default, the controller goes into fault lookout when an error occurs, meaning all outputs are shut down, and a restart is only possible after a reset and a manual start, after the error is gone, of course. For this event you see here, you can select this safety shutdown, which is also a shutdown of all outputs, and then an automatic restart after a configurable time. Now we're finished with the configuration, and here you see a summary of the settings. And you see also the resulting sequence. In this case here, you'll see, for instance, pre-purge, tightness control, ignition of ignition flame and main flame, and the shutdown of the burner. Here you can also enter the times for the steps. You can also see the inputs. Here above you see each step. These numbers refer to the step numbers you see here. At the left you see the inputs. You see three safety chains. One and two are active all the time. This safety chain is only monitored during ignition and operation. You see the input for the air pressure, both flame monitoring signals, main flame and ignition flame, and inputs for signals coming from the compartment controller. A black box means this signal in this step must be 1. White box means the signal must be 0. Deactivated gray means that this monitoring is deactivated. For instance, the flame monitoring of the main flame, we expect a 0 signal during pre-purge. During ignition, the monitoring is deactivated during the safety time, and then in the next step, we expect a 1 signal. If the signal deviates from this diagram, then a fault lockout will take place, or a safety shutdown if this is configured accordingly. Also, a diagram for the output is there. Here above you see the step numbers again. At the left you see the outputs of the block, in this case safety valve 1, safety valve 2, ignition valve, vent valve for the tightness control, ignition transformer, combustion air blower, and the output signals for the compartment controller. If the box is zero, then the output signal is, if the box is white, then the output signal is zero. If the box is black, then the output signal is one. Now we're finished. And then you see the resulting burner block with its in and outputs. The in and outputs are the in and outputs you've seen we have seen before, and also there's a start, stop, and reset input. It's now possible to connect them with the in and outputs of the modules. I've shown you the most complex configuration. I can now show you also the most simple configuration, just to show you the difference. This would be slave burner with direct ignition. You see this is grayed out because we have configured a slave burner without combustion air. Therefore this is grayed out, it's not needed anymore. This also applies to the settings for the combustion air. For the ignition valve, because it's not available anymore. Tightness control I will deactivate. And now we are finished. For this configuration you see the resulting steps are much less because other steps are not needed anymore in this configuration. And also some in and outputs we do not need anymore are here grayed out and does not need to be connected. Now this block is shown here once, but we can call this function block up to 12 times, so you can realize 12 burners with one system. All other machine safety functions are also available and can be combined with the burner control block, for instance an e-stop. I can configure an e-stop. And can connect this to the safety chain. And this is of course possible with all other safety functions. It's also possible to read out all error messages of the block, like flame error, air pressure error. These error messages are available in the diagnostic system and can also be communicated via the field bus. However, it's also possible to read out the actual step. In this case, I have a signal here available, for instance, when step 10 is active. So if step 10 is active, I can control an additional pump or a valve or anything else. And this also can be combined with logic functions, for instance, I can add another step. Step 11, for instance. And if I add an OR gate, now I have realized an extra output which is active when step 10 and 11 are active. Of course, I can add such logic also on the input side. For instance, if I want to add some step-dependent monitoring functions. All right, that's it. You have now seen how easy it is to configure the PNOZmulti for burner applications. If you need further information, please contact us. Thanks for watching.